For years, the NFL has been a major American sports league that has had many copycats trying to reap the benefits of the game of football. Leagues like the XFL, AFL, and USFL, among many other football startups, have been considered failures. Although those leagues didn't give the NFL much competition, the ABA gave the NBA a run for their money in the late 60s and early 70s before being shut down in 1976. The NBA, of course, turned into a multi-billion dollar company which turned basketball into a global game. Today, the Big Three broke out of the duplicate mold and has become the most unique sports league to date. In January 2017, hip-hop mogul Ice Cube and film producer Jeff Quatinetz founded the Big Three, a basketball league where NBA veterans could compete in 3-on-3 style basketball. The league got a warm reception and had fans dreaming of what former greats would take part. Through three seasons, stars like Allen Iverson, Chauncey Billups, Lamar Odom, and Gilbert Arenas have suited up for the league, while Hall of Famers like Clyde Drexler, Rick Barry, and Julius Erving have been seen on the sidelines as coaches. There's an age requirement of 27 years old and a requirement to have played in the NBA to enter the league. It's half court, 12 teams, 8 games per team in a different city each week, then a 2-week playoff which leads to a championship game. First of 50 points wins, and there are 2 4-point zones, which is signature of the Big Three. So how does a famous rapper think of something like this? Everyone plays 3-on-3 at the park, but how did Ice Cube turn this into a sports league? Oliver Maroney, a PR and media relations manager and writer for the Big Three, spoke with Ice Cube about the beginning of the league and how Kobe Bryant made the light bulb go off in Cube's head.
And ultimately, it comes down to one game and one instance, and that is Kobe's 61 points before he ultimately retired. And Ice Cube, being a giant LA Lakers fan, saw that Kobe still had game left. And there's so many players, he put the dots together, there's so many players who have game left, but that they're pushed out of the NBA maybe a few years too soon. So Ice Cube said, hey, I want to create something where these guys have a space to continue to play. People love to watch them play. People want to watch them play. How do we make this happen? And Jeff and him went back and forth for months on end about how it would look, what it would look like, and then obviously dropped the news that they'd be starting a 3-on-3 basketball league.
The Big Three has acted as a gateway to get back to the NBA. Most recently, Joe Johnson signed with the Detroit Pistons after spending a year in the Big Three and winning an MVP and a championship. It also allows players to prove to themselves, fans, and even family that they still got game. So, what is most striking to a player who's been out of basketball for years to be interested in suiting up again in a professional environment? Two-time NBA champion Josh Powell and co-captain of Killer Threes highlighted the fact that playing ball in the United States after years of overseas success and to be around family helped him join and likely helped others join as well.
I finished playing after my 17th year. So a way for me to be involved in the game, still compete at a high level. It's a new league. And the fact that, you know, you're able to play in the States again and you know, be around family and loved ones and things like that, man. I just had so many different reasons as to why I was very intrigued about the Big Three League.
The Big Three has gone through changes from its first season to its third, including a jump from 8 to 12 games in a season, co-captains being introduced, more players on a roster and new cities introduced. Also, each season has seen more media attention and more support from celebrities, including LeBron James, who sat courtside at Staples Center for the 2019 championship game between Triplets and Killer Threes. It's basketball, but the NBA and Big Three are different. Oliver Maroney alluded to the differences between both leagues.
We're not the NBA, and I tell people that all the time. It's not the NBA. This is not a competition between us and the NBA. You know, I think they go hand in hand in some ways, but in other ways they don't. The 3-on-3 game is much more physical. We allow hand checking. There are much more opportunities for players to be in isolation, so one-on-one opportunities. You know, you cannot hide on defense. You can't take a play off like you can potentially in the NBA. So there are marketable differences between the NBA 5-on-5 and 3-on-3, and I think that's what's grown, I think, with this game, is that people are starting to understand the differences and similarities between the two and are starting to tie them together.
10-time All-Star Carmelo Anthony hasn't been on an NBA roster since October of 2018, and some feel his game is built for the Big Three. At 35, Anthony is still an NBA-ready player, but rather than on Instagram workout videos, Anthony could use a platform like the Big Three to prove he deserves a spot on an NBA team. Josh Powell thinks Anthony would be welcomed into the Big Three with open arms, and it could revive his Hall of Fame-worthy career.
If he comes to the Big Three, I know they'll welcome him with open arms. I mean, I don't see why not, but I love him along the league.
This past summer, 2019, Ice Cube announced that the league will be expanding to China to bring Big Three basketball overseas. In November 2019, the Big Three will play 7 games there as a part of the Big Three China Tour, where 2 All-Star teams with players selected from each of the 12 teams will compete. The league will travel to 7 different Chinese cities where Big Three players will be treated like rock stars to Chinese fans.
We've always wanted to come to China. We've talked about China from day one. We wanted a league where players ran their teams. So we came up with the Big Three, professional 3-on-3 basketball, the best league 3-on-3 in the world, and we're happy to bring it here to China.
Through 3 seasons, the Big Three has made tremendous strides in-game and culturally. More and more fading NBA stars will join the league to benefit themselves over time. The league is for real, and it's a form of high-powered entertainment with a touch of nostalgia. Ice Cube is a hip-hop innovator and a basketball one, too.